road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again.
So, welcome to the Do Not Scratch Your Eyes podcast. Well, it's not a match day vlog, something a little different this evening. A little bit of culture and a little bit of history. And I'm with this lot. Justin's here.
Hello.
Peter's here. Sarah's here. Listen to the podcast and you'll find out more.
Interrupt our program to bring you this important message.
I'm observing Peter in the Watford Museum. It's a bit like letting a child out at lunchtime to run around the playground. He's very happy. Very, very happy.
I've done one for Pete, you, me and Justin, but we're in the blue away kit.
Peter's just seen the third kit and is rather excited by it.
Moist.
Moist. Horrible word. Horrible word. There's probably a boyhood moment happening here. I'm walking around Watford Museum with Nigel Gibbs. Don't get much better than that.
That's it.
Gordon Scott. A legend.
Oh, God, I used to stand there for hours.
Not working.
We all did.
Yeah.
We all did. Really? We had TV.
Nope. I'm off.
I've never seen anyone so happy to see a brick.
It's dad joke central here. Nicest man in Watford, Mr. Nigel Gibbs. What a legend, ladies and gentlemen. What a legend. Love him.
So here we are at the Vicarage Road.
exhibition, and we found Nigel Gibbs. Hello, Nigel. How are
you? I'm very well, thank you.
Good. Anything that's really taken your eye?
Well, there's obviously the Observer clock that's, it's good to see that. Flag, which is absolutely brilliant. I love that design of the W and the players. But yeah, no, there's some really good stuff here that brings back really good memories.
I'm sure.
Yeah, so there's a couple of old bricks over there which the people seem to be very excited about.
I know. Well, I've actually got that at home. I've got one of those.
You've got one of those. Yeah.
So there's a few things I've got here at home, but some of the stuff is new to me. So
Yeah, some nice memories of Vicarage Road here. It's 100 years, obviously. It's a stadium now, though, isn't it?
Oh, it's amazing. I mean, the big thing for me, whenever I go back there, obviously not this week, but the pitch is absolutely magnificent for me. Over the last few years, it's been brilliant. And obviously, the development of the stands and the hospitality and everything. I mean, the stadium's brilliant. So, the Watford fans obviously use it now to make a really good atmosphere, which is brilliant. But, you know, it's always brings back good memories. Just looking at there, the model of the stadium back when I used to go and watch
the Greyhound track or the terracing, I had to run up Monday night.
Yes, I do, yes. I remember when we won promotion running on the pitch and stuff like that versus Wrexham, great memories.
So let's just quickly talk about this season.
Yes.
How do you think we're going to do this season? I know obviously it's very early days, so there are only one game in, but so far it's been encouraging, I think.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, if the front three the other night were really dangerous, didn't they? But, you know, obviously we don't know what's going to happen in the transfer window, but you know, if you keep those three, you're going to have a really good chance. I mean, I think when you come back from the Premiership, you're always expected to, you know, be in the top six, and I think what can do, and then from there you never know, so we're going to get top two. But I think a couple of new players have come in, improved it. I think Rob's doing a great job. I think obviously some players have left, but he's trying to bring that team spirit and culture into the club. And if he gets that and everyone's working hard, I don't think the fans would ask for any more.
I think so. That's what we were asking for last season. I think at the end of last season, we said we wanted someone that was going to be long term, that was going to be young, that was going to be, you know, bringing in a new philosophy. And I think so far, I'm seeing signs that is the thing. So I'm really looking forward to it. I think how key do you think it is keeping silent? Do you think that's quite key?
I think if they want to stay and they're up for the fight and they want to really, really put the effort in for the team, then we need to keep those players because they are good players, you know, and they could be the difference to get out of the league. But we've had a lot of speculation in the press whether they're going to stay or go, but we need to score goals. We need to score goals and we need to create goals, and they certainly don't. You know, Dennis scored all the goals in the Premier League. Sarr, we know from the previous experience in the Championship how dangerous and effective he was. So I really like Pedro. I think he could really, really come on this season. It looks like he's going to be more central or playing just behind the striker. I think that's his position. But solid at the back. But he needs to score goals. And hopefully those boys can do it.
Absolutely. Well, listen, it's lovely to see you again, Nigel.
Pleasure.
Thank you very much for having the chat.
You're welcome.
Excuse me, we're chatting here.
And it comes off the.
Please don't drop it.
Oh my God, she's very nervous.
I was attracted to you mounting on a wooden plinth.
Very nervous.
Oh yes.
So there you go.
Stand on the welcome mat.
I'll stand on the mat.
Perry, it's not a playoff. It's because the club bought this one, and it's solid silver.
Solid silver?
Yeah. So I think it's estimated worth is about 50k.
Good.
Oh, put it down.
It's the same price.
Put it down. It's going. It's very expensive. Don't touch it again.
The playoff final from Cardiff.
50 grand. Don't drop it. No pressure. Too much responsibility has been given here.
No, you're all right.
Robert Page has let himself go.
Yeah, he hasn't.
Honestly. You eat too much for 20 years and everyone judges you.
Can I be Alan Chamberlain?
Did I do or not? I mean, things have got really bad now.
Thank you.
Yeah. Pretty incredible. Runners up, though. It's a shame. And that's it.
Who said piss-taking couldn't go mainstream?
And on that bombshell, it's good night.
Excuse me, we're chatting here.
Nope.